In the recent years, the news agencies have mentioned the Nagaland conflict frequently, and this even gained the attention of the national and international media. But why is there a problem in this northeastern state? Let us help you understand the problem in detail and tell you about the age-old history of Naga insurgency. Nagaland continues to witness one of the longest and bloodiest standing insurgencies, one that has existed longer than the Kashmir insurgency. The political dispute has spanned over 6 decades, and to understand it, it is important to understand the ethnicity, culture, history, geography, and demography of the Naga tribes. Nagaland is one of the smallest states in India, bordered by the state of Assam to the west, shares a very important border with Arunachal Pradesh to the north, and then Manipur to the south and Myanmar to the east. The Nagas accused the British of having betrayed them, leaving their fate in the hands of India and Burma. Nagaland was divided into 2 administrative areas, one half under India and another under Burma, now known as Myanmar. This partition of Nagaland was so indiscriminate that the house of Ang, the king, in Longwa village was said to be partitioned with his bedroom in India and his kitchen in Burma. Nagaland's demand for permanent peace has shaped a common political and cultural identity. At first, the state was never part of British India, and Indian cultures and religions have been alien to them. It was only the British missionaries that introduced Christianity to a region that practiced a multitude of folk and animist religions genealogically distinct from the practices common to India. The British first entered the Naga Hills in 1832 under an expedition led by Captain Francis Jenkins and Lieutenant Robert Boyle Pemberton. The Indo-Naga conflict has been one of the most complicated conflicts confronting post-independence India. During World War I, the British India government sent about 2,000 to 3,000 Nagas as part of the Naga Labour Corps to work in trenches as labourers and porters. When these men returned, they arrived with an awareness of common identity and culture that eventually led to the establishment of the Naga Club in 1918 in Kohima. 17 Naga tribes and 20 more sub-tribes united under the Naga National Council, NNC, in August 1947 to protest and demand an independent Nagaland. On August 14, 1947, the Nagas declared independence, and by 1954, the Indian Army moved into the Naga Hills. Still deeply affected by the violent partition of its northern reaches, Indian leaders were against any further partitioning of the country, which compounded the plight of the Naga independence struggle. Nagaland finally became the 16th state of the Indian Union in 1963, before which it was a district of Assam. Even within the Naga leadership, there was a huge difference in ideology among Angami Zapu, Fizo, T. Sakri and J.B. Jasoki. Fizo was a hardliner, while Sakri and Jasoki preferred a non-violent resolution. In this intense struggle of ideas, the very ethos that Nagaland stood for was destroyed, spiraling into a conflict that has continued for over 6 decades, the longest independent movement of its kind in the Indian subcontinent. By the mid-20th century, several rebel groups operated in Nagaland, including the Naga National Council, NNC, National Socialist Council of Nagaland, Isaac Moiva, National Socialist Council of Nagaland, Kaplang, Naga Federal Government, NFG, and Naga Federal Army, NFA. On September 6, 1964, the Suspension of Operation Agreement, AGSOP, was signed in the hopes of finally reaching a peaceful solution. Rebel groups such as NNC, NFG, and NFA were declared unlawful associations under the Unlawful Activities Prevention Act of 1967 and banned by the Centre in 1972. The South Asia Terrorism Portal reports that security forces started an extensive counterinsurgency operation, worsening the conflict further. On November 11, 1975, the Shillong Accord was signed between the center and a section of the NNC and the NFG. The agreement necessitated both groups to accept the Indian Constitution and surrender their weapons. However, a group of about 140 activists of the NNC who were in China for training rejected the Shillong Accord and formed another splinter organization calling themselves the National Socialist Council of Nagaland, NSCN, in the Burma region in 1980. At the time, NSCN had gained immense power in Northeast and became a dreaded organization. At the same time, internal conflicts among Naga tribes over regular violent clashes and killings split the NSCN further in 1988 into NSCN IM and NSCN K. The NNC itself began to lose significance and the confidence of the people. Once Fiso died in London in 1991, NSCN IM went on to become the mother of all insurgencies. The ultimate endeavor of the insurgencies has been to create a great Nagaland that includes all contiguous land, including Nagaland, where the Naga tribes are known to be settled. This would include parts of Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, and Manipur in India, as well as large tracts of land in the modern-day Myanmar. However, the idea of a greater Nagaland has remained unpopular in these regions. For the NSCN IM, the Modi government continues from where Vajpayee left. While the current dispensation has attempted to continue resolution, NSCN IM holds fast to the belief that Nagaland has never been Indian, disagreeing with Nehru's claims of inheritance of the Naga Hills from the British. At a public reception in Kohima in 2003, former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee reiterated the unique history of the Nagas. This recognition has had a lasting impression in the minds of the people. Yet, no agreement was made with the NSCNK after it attacked the Indian Army in 2015. 2 decades since, the Naga conflict remains unresolved, with no clear answers to what might finally bring peace to the people of Nagaland.